backpedaling in the face of a political backlash.
I have full faith and support for America's great intelligence agencies. I accept our intelligence community's conclusion that Russia's meddling in the 2016 election took place.
Claiming he had misspoken in statements from the previous day, the U.S. president even pointed to grammatical differences.
In a key sentence in my remarks, I said the word would instead of wouldn't. The sentence should have been, I don't see any reason why I wouldn't or why it wouldn't be Russia. So
it was the president's attempt to appease widespread criticism after he failed to stand up to the Russian president in Helsinki on Monday for Moscow's role in the 2016 U.S. presidential election. Accused of siding with an adversary instead of his own intelligence community, lawmakers in Washington questioned the president's motives.
Trump's eagerness to sell out America proves the Russians must have something personally, politically, or financially on President Trump.
But it wasn't just Democratic lawmakers. Even Trump's fellow Republicans stood firm against his comments.
Russia is a menacing government that does not share our interests, and it does not share our values. And I think that should be made very, very clear.
The top Republican senator also making it clear where U.S. allegiances lie after Trump's contentious visit to NATO last week.
We value the NATO treaty. It's been the most significant military alliance in world history. We believe the European Union countries are our friends. And the Russians are not.
And as the White House grapples with yet another firestorm, the question is whether the damage has been controlled this time around.
Republican lawmakers have until now avoided publicly criticizing the president. Helsinki seems to have changed that, but it comes as the president continues to enjoy an approval rating of nearly 90% amongst Republican voters, showing once again that despite his controversies, Trump's base remains strong. Leonie Lacani, TRT World, Washington.